Success!
I slept here in peace. This is just side of the road in Casa Grande. We are now gonna head somewhere very, very cool. And I'm gonna cross my fingers that I can get in there.
These are the abandoned domes of Casa Grande. Some of you guys might be thinking it's pronounced Grande, but, well, just like San Pedro, it's a little different from the proper Spanish pronunciation. Here we go. These are definitely a lot smaller. Whoa. How's that echo? They're a lot smaller than they appear in pictures. So, just so you can see, the front door here is like, I don't know, 9 feet tall, 8 feet tall, 10 feet tall. And this thing is the size of maybe 2 basketball courts in length. Clearly, my gosh, these echoes are insane. Clearly people come to do their art here, and, you know, probably hang out, party, you know, kids. So this is the first large structure coming in. There was another one over there which was a little smaller. Now we're back outside again. There's some very, very worn looking stuff on all that concrete here, all this orange, and very dilapidated. And just so you know, when you look it up on Google, it lists a phone number, and I did try and call the phone number multiple times, and nobody answered. I think I even texted it before. So there are no trespassing signs. There is an open driveway. You're out in the middle of nowhere, so I think, you know, the trespassing things are obviously more for legal reasons for the owner. But look at how crazy this is. Apparently it was an old manufacturing building for electronics, or it was meant to be for electronics. But I believe that it was never finished. And then the new owner, you know, I guess bought it. Not really sure why. Bought it, and the city's been trying to get them to demolish it. just so you know, around this area, holy crap. There's a lot of abandoned stuff and a lot of like dilapidated stuff. So there's like some trailers over here that look like trailers out at the Salton Sea. Totally just busted up, garbage, all that stuff. So this actually fits in well here in this neighborhood. So there is no reason for them to demolish this. It is pretty cool. And I think I'll do a few photos now. Well, I figured out what this orange material is. This is spray foam insulation. And then this is the concrete with, looks like there's metal in there for strength. Pretty cool spot, huh? So I am walking on the previous roof structure on this strange insulation here. Makes me wonder if there's any rattlesnakes down below hibernating. Definitely a cool spot. If you're into abandoned stuff, this is definitely for you. outside, you can see the foundation for more domes. There's one here, there's another one that's 2, 3, right there. I believe there were some over the, on the other side as well. So, this is, wow, isn't this something? Now, I don't know about you, but these are my kinds of roadside attractions. I definitely prefer this to the, little stop along Route 66 selling old memorabilia and things like that. I like more of this kind of stuff, you know? Some really, really unique, hard to find, interesting, and very photogenic stuff here. This is a really cool place. Kind of makes me wish I had some spray paint. Holy echo. Now if you stand, this is the first dome closest to the road. It's the smallest, as you can see. We'll do a slow pan here. If you stand right in the middle, it creates an amazing echo. Why they would want to manufacture computer components in an echo chamber, I have no idea. You'd have some very, very terrible dreams at night when you go home from work if you work in this echo chamber. All right, let's fly the drone. Today's video was a super cool place that I've wanted to see now for maybe over a year. I will be flying out, and I'm gonna, like I said before, stagger the videos, so I may or may not film up in Portland. I will be bringing my camera along, and I got some new fun things for the bus here. I got the United States sticker map thing. And got some good tea for my kidneys. And I got this package from Eric Casey on YouTube. And I'm going to wait to open it until I get back. I don't know how he got the address to Austin, but he sent it to Austin. I missed him and it took forever to get. So, yeah, I'm going to batten down the hatches, get it ready. And then tomorrow I'm going to be flying by air. So I'll catch you guys in the next upload. Thanks for watching.